As we continue with the Women of Vision Awards this evening, I'd like to introduce the chair of ABI's Board of Trustees. She is the Dean of Engineering and Distinguished Professor at Purdue University, as well as a member of the National Academy of Engineering and winner of the National Academy of Engineering's Gordon Prize. Please welcome Leah Jameson.
Thank you, Penny. I am so glad you are all here tonight. Has anybody mentioned how truly fabulous it is to spend an evening with several hundred of the most inspired and inspiring women in the world? This is an event to remember. We're celebrating Women of Vision. The event is organized by the Anita Borg Institute. It's an organization I've been involved with since its inception. ABI was organized initially to support another event, the Grace Hopper Celebration of Women in Computing. Since that first Hopper Conference in 1994, GHC has evolved to connect, inspire, and guide women in computing. It brings together women pursuing careers in technology, and it increases the visibility of the contributions women are making to the field and to the world. I attended that first Grace Hopper celebration in 1994, and it literally took my breath away to be in a room with 500 women in technology. And look at us tonight. I'm therefore especially honored to announce that the Estrin family has endowed 3 Grace Hopper Celebration Scholarships annually in memory of their mother, Dr. Thelma Estrin. Thelma Estrin Thelma Estrin was truly a pioneer in computing. She developed her interest in engineering while working at the Radio Receptor Company, building electronic devices during World War II. She went on to earn her PhD from the University of Wisconsin-Madison. She and her husband, Jerry, later went to Israel, where they helped to build the first computer there, the Weizmann Automatic Computer. After their return, Thelma became associated with the Brain Research Institute at UCLA and became a professor of computer science at UCLA in 1980. Thelma was a fellow of the IEEE, fellow of the American Academy of Arts and Sciences, and a founding fellow of the American Institute for Medical and Biological Engineering. She was on the board of advisors for the Anita Borg Institute for many years and an active advocate for women in computing. It is therefore with great joy and pleasure that I welcome to the stage Thelma's daughter, Judy Estrin.
Thank you, Leah, and congratulations to all of the Women of Vision that are here, some being formally recognized, and many more that are not. My sisters and I were very fortunate to grow up in an environment where we were immersed in science and engineering and raised by 2 strong role models who believed in equality for women in the workplace and especially in engineering. Throughout our mother's career, she demonstrated a passion for encouraging more women to become engineers, way before it was a popular cause. In going through her papers recently, we found a letter she wrote in 1959 to the Society of Women Engineers about fundraising strategies, as well as a paper from 1978 titled Upward Mobility and Career Development for Women Engineers. Upon her passing, it seemed natural to honor her contributions and career by recognizing and furthering this cause. Those of you who had an opportunity to meet Thelma know that she did not hold back when she thought a person or organization could do better, or daughter. I ad-libbed, sorry. But from the beginning, she always had positive things to say about Anita Borg and the Anita Borg Institute. She enjoyed attending the Grace Hopper conferences while she still could, and we are glad that she will continue to have a presence at the conference, represented each year by the three women who receive one of these scholarships. Telly and team, thank you for all of the critical work you do in supporting women in engineering and computer science. Thank you.
Thank you, Judy. It's through the generosity of people like the Estrin family and the achievements of women like Thelma Estrin that the magic of GHC happens, and it is indeed magic. We are honored by the Estrin family's generous endowment in memory of their mother, Thelma Estrin. The Grace Hopper Conference this year will take place October 8th through 10th in Phoenix, Arizona. And okay, Phoenix people here. From that initial conference in 1994, GHC has grown to include not 500 women, but more than 4,700 women from 53 countries with over 350 companies represented, making it the largest conference for women in technology in the world. Tonight, students representing the university shown on the screen have joined us. Many organizations have helped share the vision of tonight's banquet by sponsoring these students. And we hope to see all these students and many more at GHC this fall. So please enjoy this video to share some of that magic that is GHC.
I first met Anita when I moved to Silicon Valley. She was a researcher at what was then DEC Research Lab. In 1992, she came to me with this idea of bringing together women who were already working in the computing area and to celebrate their success. At a restaurant in downtown Palo Alto, the ideas of the Grace Hopper Celebration of Women in Computing Conference were originally started. Neither of us knew how to create a conference, but we had a passion for innovation and an entrepreneurial idea of what it might look like. Every woman we asked to speak at that first conference agreed. For me to walk into the room of that first conference and to see over 500 women really excited about what they were doing, it was a life-changing experience. The organization has grown. The number of people we reach, the impact that we have. Anita's spirit is in everything that we do. She had this vision of women in computing everywhere, making a difference. I think she would be proud if the work that we do in her name is having such a global impact.